that were not in the panel this morning, about halfway through the panel, I had a box arrive from Houston, right there. That's the box of which I speak. And in that box was a present for you. I wish I had like a microphone to record all of this. About a year and a half ago, I wanted to do something to give back to the fans. You guys have been so kind and so supportive of my work, and you have blessed my life. You have been a gift to me more than I could ever tell you. We don't make a lot of money, okay? If anyone's thinking, oh, I'm going to be a mortgage actor, I'm going to be a witch. Never happened. We don't make a lot of money, but what we don't make in money, I could not ever put a price on how much you guys mean to me and how much I appreciate your kindness and your support. So in that sentiment, about a year and a half ago, I thought, what can I do for the fans as a way of saying thank you? So I thought, well, what's precious to me? My faith is very important to me. So you know what I did? I recorded the entire Gospel of John from the Bible, like 21 chapters. It's a big friggin' book. Sorry, Martin, I just called your book friggin'. But now, let me dispel any rumors yet. Oh, wow, I can't wait to hear Edward Elric read the King James Version of the Bible. No. Because I'm going to do any of that. This really contemporary translation is very cool. It's the way we talk nowadays. I mean, it's really awesome. And it's called The Message. Yeah. But then when I got done, oh, by the way, I like gave voices to some of the different characters. So you have the disciples, you have Mary Magdalene. Yes, I did Mary Magdalene. You know, Jesus, of course. And again, let me dispel rumors right now. No, Jesus does not sound like Bert Mousy. Although that would be possible. That would be really kind of weird, wouldn't it? Yeah. Follow me. I feel it doesn't work. Yeah. All right, everybody wipe that off your brain. The preacher's gonna read something, Peter, follow me. What are you laughing at, my child? Oh, nothing. Nothing. Thought it was a funny show. Okay. But I did all these voices, and then when I got done, I'm like, you know, what could make this easier to listen to? What can I do to make this easier to listen to? Because that's obviously, ultimately, that's what I would want for you, is to listen to it. So I went all the way back to the beginning, chapter 1, and I played the piano underneath the whole thing. Basically like scoring it, like putting music to score the story and the scenes and the chapters. And it turned out really good. I'm very pleased with it. I had several friends who liked this idea, and we all put some money together and pressed like 5,000 of them, so that I could give them to you at conventions for free. I have them, and I want you to have them. So if you like one, we're having an autograph session right after this. You know that, right? So, who liked this one? The other thing, I have a brand new piano CD. I know for a lot of you, piano is not really your thing, but I have this piano CD called Sela, which is kind of, how many of you would like an interesting bit of trivia? I was looking for a way to name this piano CD years ago. It's just instrumental piano music, but it's not meant to be like showy or flashy. It's just meant to like provide a calming, relaxing kind of an atmosphere for maybe you're studying, or you've had a long day, or you're in traffic, or you know what I'm saying, or you just got off of work, or can't go to sleep, and you just want to chill a little bit. And I was trying to think of the right title for such an album. And then somebody said, why don't you use that word that's in the Psalms, in between the Psalms? David would write a psalm, you know, like, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. And then at the end, they would say, Selah. I grew up in church, I didn't even know what Selah meant. And then I looked it up, and you know what it means? It's a musical pause for reflection. Pause to reflect upon what you just heard. And I'm like, that's perfect. So I called my piano CD Selah, and I just released Selah 2.
Revenge of the Selah.
Hold on, it's not. It's not really that.
Son of Selah.
This time it's war. And also, I just released, how many of you have my Christmas CD from last year, maybe? I released a Christmas CD last year. I had people for years going, what is your Christmas CD? What is your... Okay, I'll do that. So I made one. It's got a lot of the standards on it, but they're all really nice arrangements, original arrangements. And then it's got some original songs as well. Well, I hurried up and got it out last year before Christmas, and I always wanted to do some more things to it. So I added some new songs, and fixed a couple of, one of them's an original, and another one is like a, it's like a reggae version of Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. It's funny, isn't it? It starts off like this. You start to hear this little steel drum, and you hear this guy go, okay, this is a Christmas story I like about a deer. So that's on here. And you know what? I always got criticized because I never put the titles on the back. People are like, you want to throw it? You know, they always pick up a CD. What's the first thing they do? Look to see what songs are on it. Well, I'm an idiot. I don't know the design, but I didn't even think that. I don't want to cover up the pictures. So I didn't want to put the words on it, but now I've got the titles on here, so if you're interested in knowing what's on here, they're on here. And I've got just a handful of CDs left, and I'll have those at the autograph session after, along with the Gospel of John. Now, how can it keep